all rise as we prepare our hearts and mind to worship God tonight.
Thank you.
only by your grace we are here today, Father. We thank you for gathering us in your name, Lord. We lift this time up to you, Lord. Open our hearts, our minds to your word, Lord. We commit this time to you. In your name we pray. Amen. And amen.
Amen. Palakpakan ulit po natin ang Panginoon. Thank you, Lord. You may sit down. Pwede niyo pong batiin ang kakatabi niyo. You may greet person beside you. How are you? How's the first day of fasting? Nahihilo ba? Nagugutom? Okay. Alright. So, we're so blessed to have again another, our annual prayer and fasting week. No? So, our topic for, or the theme, or the whole week is pray in faith, victory in surrender. No? So, and tonight, I am blessed to be and privileged to speak about healing, right? And I think sobrang relatable to sa lahat sa atin, because one way or another, the past pandemic for 2 years, you know, we've encountered a lot of sickness and health problems, emotional, mental, and even relational. So the thing or the question that always runs in our mind is that, how can I pray in faith for healing? Meron ba kayo narinig ng ganun? Let's pray. Baka kailangan ng healing no ano ko. Sige, Lord, we thank you and lift up to you this time. We ask you, Lord, that you just help us as we come together and worship you and really learn more about you as our healer. Thank you, in Jesus' name. Amen, amen. Okay, answered prayer agad, no? Wala. Alright, so before we go to our passage for tonight, no? So let me just tell you one thing, that God, as a loving Father, never planned for people to be sick. Right? Naniniwala ba kayo doon? That God, as a loving Father, when He created human being, and also as His children, hindi po niya intended plan for us to be sick. No father or even no parent would want his child or his children to be sick. No? And sickness happened, nangyari po to, when sin entered. You know, when mankind chose to disobey God's design and follow Satan. Right? Another truth that we can learn from the Bible is Satan also is the one who causes us to be sick. Right? Saan po natin makita yan? In John 10:10, it states there that the thief comes only to kill, steal, and destroy. Right? Yan lang po yung agenda ni Satan and yung mga dominions niya sa atin. To kill, steal, and destroy. But in Jesus, with God, in His kingdom, He came so that we can have life. In John 10:10, in the same verse, it says there, I came, Jesus was speaking, sinabi niya, that you may have life. But not just any kind of life. Have it abundantly. Meaning to the fullest. Right? So our topic po for tonight is pray in faith to Jesus our healer. Sabihin mo sa katabi mo, pray in faith to Jesus our healer. Some of you here may be experiencing or have experienced physical sickness. Others may be emotional, mental. But what, regardless of the situation you are right now, I encourage you to pray in faith to Jesus, our healer. So now let's go to our text. In Luke chapter 18, verse 35 to 39. Sabayan niyo po ako sa pagbabasa. Verse 35. As Jesus was approaching Jericho, a blind man was sitting by the road begging. Now hearing a crowd going by, he began to inquire what this was. They told him that Jesus of Nazareth was passing by. And he called out saying, Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me. Those who led the way were sternly telling him to be quiet. But he kept crying out all the more, son of David, have mercy on me. So in this passage, we have three characters. It's Jesus, the blind man, and a crowd, right? So in here, makikita po natin, how did the blind man knew about Jesus, right? So, si Jesus po kasi was really someone na parang sikat eh, di ba? He really makes a lot of noise when he's around. People would really tend to gather around him. It's either to hear his teaching, to be healed, or even just to just be near him, right? So, as we notice here, the blind man, no, sitting by the road begging. So, probably matagal na po siya talagang blind, and he was there. Now, hearing a crowd, sabi niya, he began to inquire. So, the blind man, nalaman niya about Jesus when he began to inquire, right? Kasi may mga nagtatanong-tanungan, may ingay, eh, di ba? Why do you think that the blind man wanted to know about this, right? Because of his status, of his sickness, right? So what did he do? What did this blind man do to seek and approach the Lord, right? What did the blind man do to seek and approach the Lord? As we can see in the text, he called out, right? He called out. And to whom did he call out? To Jesus of Nazareth. To Jesus. So what can we learn here? Question is, when we are sick, when we experience sickness, no, when we experience turmoil in our life, to whom do we call out first when we need healing? Right? To whom do we call out first when we need healing? Is it doctor, family, friends, neighbors? Nothing wrong po with that. Pero most of the time, we do forget to call to Jesus. Right? Minsan, kadalasan huling-huli pa natin siya. Siya pa yung pinakahuling natatawagin natin kapag malalang-malala na. Right? And what I have learned here is when in sickness, we need to pray in faith to Jesus because He is our healer. Kahit gano'n pa po ka-minor yung sickness, kahit inuubo ka lang, di ba? Or nadapa ka lang, nagasgasan ka lang. Right? The Bible always encourages us to pray for everything. Right? Because yun po yung heart ni God for us, is to come to Him. Especially in times of healing, times like this. Sometimes when we pray, we don't get answers quickly. No? Sometimes may discouragement po. Like here, happening here, in verse 39, right? So, of course, when he inquired, he knew that this was Jesus, and of course, given the profile of Jesus, he wanted to get healed, but there was a crowd was discouraging him, right? In verse 39, sabi doon, those who led the way were sternly telling him to be quiet, right? Have you experienced that? Na sometimes you know you need help, you want to go to Jesus or you really need some encouragement, but you're being sternly told, be quiet. Ah, wala yan. Ah, inuman mo lang yan ng Bajesic. Ay, ikaw kasi hindi ka masyadong ano, di ba? Right? Sometimes we would really experience that even in our sickness, but God allows that for a purpose, no? But what we can learn here, dito po sa blind man, is he had the right response. And the proper response is, he kept crying out all the more. Right? He kept crying out all the more, Son of David, Jesus, have mercy on me. Right? Have mercy on me. At tagal ko ng bulag. Gusto kong makakita. That was his response to discouragement. So, what can we learn here from the blind man? No? When in sickness, keep praying in faith to Jesus, our healer. Sabi mo sa katabi mo, keep praying in faith to Jesus, our healer. Right? Huwag po tayo agad mag-give up. Kunyari, nag-pray lang tayo, hindi agad na-heal. Diba? Or hindi pa natin nakikita yung results. We ought to keep praying. Right? We ought to go to God like this blind man. Let's go to our next few verses in Luke chapter 18, verse 40 to 43. No? So, Jesus heard him, right? And Jesus stopped and commanded that he be brought to him. And when he came near, he questioned him, "What do you want me to do for you?" Wow. Isipin mo, Lord of Lords, King of Kings, asking you, "What do you want me to do for you?" And he said, "Lord, I want to regain my sight." And Jesus said to him, "Receive your sight. Your faith has made you well." And immediately he regained his sight and began following him, glorifying God. And when all the people saw it, they gave praise to God. So Jesus' response to him is that he stopped, right? Jesus stopped. And what we can learn here is that anyone who seeks Jesus, who seeks God, he is never too busy to stop for you, right? Regardless of who you are, when you come to him in humility, in prayer, he is never too busy to stop. Kasi malamang may schedule na siya yan. Ang daming tao. Pero he took time to stop and address the need of this blind man. So how did the Lord heal the blind man? Right? Tinanong niya, "What do you want me to do for you?" Sabi niya, "Lord, I want, gusto makita." Right? So the blind man was honest of himself. "Lord, gusto makita." Right? And sometimes, we ought to be honest in our prayers as well. We ought to be transparent. Hindi yung, "Lord, hindi, okay lang kasi, ganun naman talaga, Lord." You know? We can always be truthful, authentic, at the same time, respectful to God our Father. Because that's what He wants, right? He was there, authentic. "Lord, gusto ko makita. I want to regain my sight," right? So how did He heal him? Simple, by word of mouth. Right, by word of mouth. Sinabi niya lang, "Receive your sight." Wala nang, yung sa mga movies, yung magic, di ba? Ganun. Hindi, simple. Parang feeling ko, ganito lang yung conversation eh. "O, anong gusto mong gawin ko sa'yo?" "Lord, gusto ko makakita." "Receive your sight." And, ano nangyari? Di ba? Ano nangyari? Immediately, quickly, di ba? He regained his sight. Immediately. In a blink of an eye. Imagine mo, buong buhay mo, bulag ka. Immediately, makakita. 20/20 vision. Right? Hindi progressively. Immediately, he regained his sight. Right? And malalaman natin na, when you know, when Jesus heals, syempre hindi naman niya bibigyan na hindi 20/20 vision. Diba? Kasi God siya. And He wants what's good and best for us. But what do you think Jesus, why did Jesus extend His healing touch to this blind man? Well, here we can learn that Jesus, you know, heals people so that we can give glory to God, right? After immediately regaining his sight, it was told there in the Bible, the blind man began what? Anong ginawa? Yes, he followed Jesus. Right? That is the right response. When we experience healing for ourselves, to our families, we ought to follow him. But not only to follow him, but to bring glory to God's name. And at the same time, you know, tell people about it. Because when they saw this, what happened? They all gave praise to God, right? That is the purpose of God, why He heals people, so that we can follow Him, believe in Him, and give glory and honor to His name, right? Can you repeat this? Our topic for tonight, what's our topic? Pray in faith to Jesus, our healer. In closing, this is my personal testimony of healing in our family. You know, 2 years has been tough for us, especially in 2021. My dad was diagnosed with enlarged prostate, possible of having cancer. Noong June 21, 2021, brother ko naman, 2 a.m., kumatok sa pinto namin na talagang nag-ano na yung sakit. Yung pala, may gallbladder stones na siya. He got operated. Sinama ko po siya dun nung inoperahan siya. Then after he went out from the operation, 2 days after, I tore my ACL, left knee. And then at nung August naman, my Tita Abing had an aneurysm. We had to look for an hospital for her. Yung mom ko, 11 p.m., naghahanap ng hospital, nakahanap sila 4 a.m. I wanted to bring my tita to the hospital, but yung operation ko malapit na. So my wife told me, wag ka na sumama, aba hindi ka pa maoperahan. So that was a tough decision also for us. And then September 21, my tita, another tita in the province, got COVID pneumonia, and we thought that she will die. Kasi sobrang grabe. Sobrang grabe. Then December 2021, yung in-laws ko got COVID as well. And then on June 2022, bago po magpabaptize yung mama ko, three days before, nagkaroon siya ng broken nose. But what am I... I'm sharing this because when I look back, I just can't imagine paano po namin nalampasan lahat po ito. Right? During those times, the only thing that I was really praying for was, Lord, please help us. You know, aside also from the financial challenges. With this one, you know, we and our family, when we look back, parang, you know, if we didn't have Jesus, if we didn't have God, sa ibang pamilya would have breakdown. Right? Sunod-sunod. Sunod-sunod talaga siya. But now, you know, yung papa ko, benign yung prostrate niya. My brother has fully recovered. I have fully recovered. Yung tita Abing ko rin, fully recovered, you know, and pati yung tita Mina ko. Pati rin po yung in-laws ko. And yung mama ko, yun nga, no, last July 2, hindi ko nga alam kung paano siya nagpabaptize. Nagpabaptize siya ng broken nose. Di ba? So all glory to God and everything. But you know what the reason why I'm sharing this is because, you know, we couldn't have gone through this tough health challenges if Jesus was not with us, right? If we didn't pray in faith to Jesus, our healer. Is it always like that? Is it always in victory when I pray faith in Jesus? Meron rin po na times that when we prayed in faith to Jesus, you know, our prayers was not answered. Right? Like yung huling pinsan ko na pinag-pray po namin, he passed away, you know. But does that mean that I should stop praying in faith to Jesus if I don't get the result that I want? Of course not. Right? Of course not. Because when Jesus does not answer your prayer about faith in healing, he always have a better purpose. You can look at that in the Bible. It happened to Lazarus. You know, when he didn't heal Lazarus, what did he do? He raised him from the dead. Kay Paul, nagkasakit siya. He begged up 3 times, but he didn't took it. Right? Because he was teaching him to be Christ-like, to be humble. And our encouragement for all of us today is that regardless of the answer of God, regardless if God will heal or not, the thing that we can bank on is that Jesus can heal. He is God. He is the power. He has authority. So, my encouragement to you is always pray in faith to Jesus, our healer. He has the power to heal, but we also have the responsibility to come to Him in faith. His purpose for healing is to point people to Him, accept Him in faith, and bring glory to God. Let's pray. Lord, thank you for tonight. We lift up to you, Lord God, our hearts, that we may be surrendered to you. Lord, we ask for each and every one of us for healing as well to those who are hurting, to those who are in need of miracle. Lord, the miracle is you, you alone, Lord Jesus. And we pray that as we surrender, as we come to you in faith and surrender the results to you, may your presence, Lord God, manifest. May your presence, Lord, bring comfort. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you, everyone.
Amen and amen. Bigyan po natin ng
praise item clap ang ating Panginoon for our first day of Night Watch, your devotion. Thank you, Claude. Thank you for encouraging us through God's Word. And thank you for letting us know that healing do really happen. But at the end of the day, healing comes in God's perfect timing. Do you agree with that? It's God's perfect timing. So thank you, everyone, for just being here and encouraging all of us. We're so blessed that, you know, this is our first face-to-face Night Watch in January. Because last year, we tried doing that mid-year. And we're happy to share to you that our number last year, mid-year, was that the biggest number that attended our Night Watch last year nung July, nung mid-year, was 102 or 103. Kasi po, meron, yun po yung Sabado, yung meron tayong Toko at Baboy. I think yung Toko at Baboy at Lugaw ang nagdala sa kanila nung Sabado. But today is our first day and we're really blessed that there are 99 of you here this morning, this evening, plus there are still 46 online. So mga 100, close to 150 po tayo for this year's mid-year, for this year's prayer and fasting. We're so blessed. And that's why we all want to welcome you in behalf of Pastor Bert, Chito, and myself. I'd like to welcome you to our first night of our night devotion. 6 days po natin gagawin to. Okay? So wag po kayo mawawala ng lakas na dapat for 6 days. You will all be here and join us as we come to a time of praying. Do you believe that more than the privilege of really lifting our prayers to the Lord, do you believe that the best way we could really pray in faith and victory in surrender is to be together and worship the Lord and thank Him? And I think that is really why you're here all tonight. And that's why, you know, this is what we have. I think some of you might be joining us for the very first time. So if you don't have a copy of our booklet, because in the booklet, I think we have extras here later on. Pero pag nakakuha na kayo, nakalimutan nyo lang, huwag na po kayo kumuha, ha? Pag meron na kayo sa bahay, baka nakalimutan nyo lang, huwag na kayo kumuha. But if you haven't really had a copy, please get it. Why? Because in here, you'll find out all the things that you can want to know more about why we are fasting. You know, it's important that we understand the biblical reason why we fast. And also, if for those of you that are earth-friendly, pwede po ma-download. Meron po akong kopya sa telepono ko, meron po ako pong kopya sa computer ko. So you could actually have a digital copy of this. So please read it, understand it, and carefully study also the devotions that are here. You know, one of the things that I am personally blessed when it's a time of our annual full week prayer and fasting is really the ability to silence the world and allow me to focus on God. Ito pong linggo na to, whenever I come to a time of prayer and fasting, I don't know, for one strange reason, when I'm not eating food, naririnig ko po talaga ang Panginoon. And I pray that is what you will encounter this week as you seek the Lord in prayer. So please have this. All right, now what we're gonna do, remember, is prayer and fasting. So I hope also, I want to encourage you. I know there are some of you who might not have tried food fast. Pero po, object fast. Meaning, hindi po kayo nagsa-social media, hindi po kayo nanonood ng TV, or hindi kayo nanonood ng movies, or whatever. But if you're here and you haven't really tried the food fast, I sincerely challenge and invite you to experience the amazing adventure of not eating food for a few days. So please, if you haven't tried it, I really want to encourage you. So it's fasting, and then it's praying. And that's why at this point, you would now come to a time of praying to the Lord. And today, and just like any other days, we will follow this simple mental outline on how do we really pray. So in the next few minutes, we'll give you about 25 minutes to really come to the Lord in a time of pray. P-R-A-Y. What does P-R-A-Y mean? Kasi normally, when I first tried this out, kasi baka may mga iba sa inyo ngayon lang po magpe-prayer and fasting, paano pinagdadasal ng 25 minutes, ng 30 minutes? Kasi minsan iba, 2 minutes lang, wala na po pwedeng pagdasal. Right? Kasi natapos na. But here, we're trying to really cultivate a lifestyle of prayer. And one way to really cultivate that is to really go into a time of prayer. And what do? First, we pray, and P is pause. Okay? P is pause. Nagkamali lang po dito. No? Hindi to po pray. So it's pause. So pray is the acronym, but P is pause. Okay, what does pause mean? Pause and pray means you need to pause and reflect
on who God is. So the first thing that you need to understand to really be able to cultivate a lifestyle of prayer is first think about who God is. Isipin niyo po, ano po ba yung ginagawa niya sa buhay niyo? Ano po ba, sino po ba talaga siya? You reflect on that and you respond to Him in worship. I don't know with you, but every time I think about who God is and what He has done, amazingly, He puts my problems into shambles. Kung baga may problema ako iniisip, imbis na isipin ko po yung problema, I'll think about who God is. And you know what? The problem seems to really pale in comparison to an amazing God He is. That's why in the P part, in the pause part, you will try to adore Him for who He is and thank Him for what He has done. You could be silent before the Lord, or you could actually say something verbally. You know, dito kasi sa Pilipinas, hindi uso or hindi tayo komportable pag yung katabi natin nagdadasal ng maingay. Right? Parang nakatingin ka, but nagkasalita to, right? But you know what? In other churches, when you go in a time of prayer, ang ingay. Because everybody is just praising the Lord and thanking Him. So, if you want that, you could do that. Pwede ka rin po kayong kumanta kung gusto nyo. Okay, siguraduhin na po natin nasa tono tayo. But, you know, but I think the purpose is really on the heart, not the singing part. But that's the part. You pause for a time. And then R is that you would now repent. The reason for this, the natural flow of this is when you think about the holiness of God, you see your own sinfulness. Doon mo makikita yung kasalanan mo. Doon mo makikita yung mga pagkukulang mo. So the more you understand who God is, the more you understand His holiness and what He has done, the more you will understand the need for you to repent. So the next is after you pause, after you worship, you pray. You examine yourself. You repent from your sins, your shortcomings, your self-centeredness, and in fact, even your delayed disobedience. And then you confess to God and receive His cleansing mercy. So pause, and then repent. And then A is to ask. Tonight, we will ask specifically on healing and health. So when you lift up your petitions to the Lord, it's about healing. It's about health. And that's why Claude shared to us the message about the blind man finding sight, no? And I like what he mentioned about, no, the reply is whenever we're not yet getting the answer, is to pray more, to cry out to the Lord more. And I pray that that is what you're going to do tonight, which is to pray for healing and for health. And then lastly, P-R-A, and then Y is to yield. Yield means you need to take the time to surrender yourself. You need to yield to God's perfect plan and perfect timing. Hindi po yung timing natin, hindi po yung plano natin, but plano ng Panginoon. And that's why when you do that, when you yield to the Lord and surrender our own personal petitions and our own and anything that else that burdens your heart, and in that aspect, you know, it doesn't have to be health, it doesn't have to be healing, it can be anything that is in your burden. As you yield that to the Lord, ask the Lord to really just answer it in His amazing, pleasing, and perfect way. And that's how we spend time in prayer. P, pause, worship the Lord, and then R, repent, and then A, ask, and then Y, yield. At this point, we'd now want to give that time to you. I-apply na po natin to. So you could either pray together if you're with someone that you know, or you could pray alone, or you could pray in groups, whatever it is that you want. And then at around 8:25, after about 20 minutes, I will then come in and close our time to the Lord in prayer. Is that okay? Are we all ready now to come to the Lord in prayer? Okay, everybody, let me just pray and then commit this time. Panginoon, marami pong salamat for this first night watch. Thank you for your word. Thank you for your message to include about what it is to really yield to you, that you are our divine healer and that you have the power to heal. But it also showcased our responsibility, and our responsibility is to seek you, to come to you in faith. And Father, I pray that as we come to you and seek your presence and seek your healing, that the purpose is really eventually to point people to you, that we need to accept you in faith, and then in the process, bring glory to you. Lord, bless your people. Bless the prayers of your people as they pray to you their concerns and lift up to you their hearts tonight. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's now spend this time in prayer.